Good morning, guys. My name's Arjun. So today, what we shall be talking would be what is the difference between my capital and revenue. So we shall be talking of why is capital and revenue differentiation important, how are their treatments done, and also we shall be looking into it in terms of finding out profits, losses, certain examples which are going to be dealt in an exam with regards to the capital and revenue expenditure. With regards to your marks, generally you can expect a true or false question which comes out of it, or maybe a theory question. Average, if you ask me, it's going to be between 1 or 2 marks. So I would not prefer you guys to spend more time on this. But conceptually, from a long-term perspective of understanding accounts, it's a lot more important. So what we shall be covering in this chapter is, we'll first try identifying what is a capital payment, what's a capital receipt, revenue payments and a revenue receipt, how the treatment is done for both the items, and taking certain examples, and then trying to find out what is capital and what is revenue. So let me first comment with why classification of an item into capital or revenue is important. When I say an item is to be classified as capital or revenue, this entirely affects the way I present, because all the capital items appear in my balance sheet and all my revenue items appear in my income statement. Now that is why differentiation becomes quite important for me, because all my capital items, as I told, where does it come? Balance sheet, right? And my revenue items is going to be coming in my P&L account, or we call it a statement of income. So how do you differentiate something into a capital item or a revenue item? Now let's try looking into various considerations what we shall be following to identify something to be a capital or a revenue. The first thing, so I told you we will be talking about the consideration and discussion between capital and revenue expenditure. First thing is the nature of business. Now when I say a nature of business, I'll try first going through an example of this. Let's say I purchase a land. Now when I purchase a land, generally we all say, hey, you know what, land is going to be used for long term, it's a capital item, where somebody might say it's a revenue. Now my question is capital, is purchase of a land a capital item or a revenue item? Now let's say I am a land dealer. So what does a land dealer do? He's going to buy the and sell the land. So when I'm buying and selling a land, the first part is, what is my primary objective of the business? Buying and selling of the good. That means I'm going to make my money out of buying and selling land. I'm not owning land for the purpose of my production or any of it. So for a person who's a land dealer, purchase of land becomes a revenue expenditure. Whereas let's say I'm actually owning a factory, I am into a manufacturing of particular goods or service. So purchase of a land there becomes a capital item. So let's try understanding it. If I'm a furniture dealer, my objective of buying a furniture is to sell, then purchase of furniture becomes my revenue. Again, I'm telling you, I am a furniture dealer. Objective is to sell the furniture. Then by purchase and selling of furniture becomes the same furniture dealer. If the idea is to use in business for long term, then we say that to be capital. I hope you guys have understood it. So I told you the first part is nature of business. I told you what makes it. is whether I'm buying it for my own purpose or for you selling purpose. And if I'm a land dealer, buying and selling of land becomes a capital revenue. Whereas if I'm a normal businessman, for me, buying of a land becomes a capital item because the idea is to use it for long term. Second item, now recurring nature of expenditure. Now, if I ask you guys a question, would you end up buying a building every month and try to sell? Or are you going to buy a building for using it for a long-term purpose? When do you pay salary? Do you pay salary monthly or do you pay somebody a salary for 10 years at one shot? So a capital expenditure, you will not get into a habit of buying or selling regularly. So you are not in an objective to buy or sell regularly. Now, if your objective is to buy and sell regularly, it becomes revenue. Whereas if your objective is to buy or sell once in a time, then it becomes a capital expenditure. So capital expenditure is usually one time, not something which happens regularly. The next item which we shall be looking into it, what is the purpose of expense? Now, if the expense is to increase, is it for increasing efficiency or is it to maintain the existence property? Let's say for an example, I have a particular car which was giving me a mileage of 20 kilometers per hour. So my car was giving a mileage of 20 kilometers per liter. Now, after 5 years, the mileage dropped to 12. I did repairs to increase my mileage from 12 to 18. The money what I'm spending, if you look into it, it is well within the original capacity of 20. This expense will become maintenance. So we call it as revenue expenditure. Again, I'm telling you, since the money what I've spent is only for maintaining my mileage within its original capacity. If I spend some money and because I spend this money, the mileage went above 25 kilometers per liter. Now, if you look into it, it is increasing efficiency. We call such items to be capital expenditure. Now, let's come to the next one. Revenue generating capacity. Now, if you ever spend a money and that money is going to lead to increasing your revenue. For an example, you are originally producing 10,000 units in a machine. Now, because of this new addition, it started producing 20,000 units. Therefore, this expenditure, whatever you would have incurred on this machine, we call such items to be capital expenditure. Now, if the expense is done and it's not going to increase my capacity, it's going to leave it as it is, 10,000 itself, then we can say that expenditure to be my revenue expenditure. So if it increases your revenue, any expenditure, we call it to be capital. If it does not, then we call it to be revenue. The last one, materiality. This is basically, we say, is the amount involved. If the amount involved is lesser, let's say for an example, purchasing of calculator, 1200 rupees. 1200 rupees, I know this calculator is bought with the objective to use it for a longer period of time. But since I shall be using it very lesser, we call that expenditure of my, the amount what I'm spending is lesser. We call, even though it's used for a longer period of time, I call it to be my revenue expenditure. Same thing, let's say I bought a computer by paying 50,000. This, the quantum is larger, we call it to be capital. Usually, whenever I have to classify something into capital or revenue, let's try looking into all this together. Then it makes sense. Now, first thing I told you was I shall be looking into the nature of business. Example you can always remember is the land dealer. Recurring expenses, capital expenditure is one time, whereas revenue is more than once in a year. You have to look into the purpose. Is it going to improve efficiency or is it going to maintain the efficiency? Revenue generating, is it going to increase revenue or is it to maintain the revenue? Materiality is the quantum. So I shall be using all of this five together so that I figure out whether the item is a capital or a revenue item. I hope you guys are clear with this. Now, I want you guys to say whether it's a true or false. An overall expense of a second-hand machinery purchased are revenue expenditure. What do you mean by an overall expense first? An overall expense basically means an expense which is made to make sure the second-hand machinery becomes as good as a new machine. So we say a machine which is getting altered because you had used it for a longer period of time, you're doing a revamp so that it becomes like a new machine. And since it becomes like a new machine, I get a long-term advantage. So this, for me, for the guy who's selling, it might be a used machine, but for me, even though it is second-hand, it is my first, or we say a new machine, therefore my, it's a long-term advantage, so we call it to be a capital expenditure. So the answer is false. Now I want you guys to take a look into it. Money spent to reduce working expense is a revenue expense. Money spent to reduce working expenses is a revenue expense. Now if you reduce working expense, what will happen to the profit? The profit will increase. If the profit is increasing, can it be revenue? The answer is no, it shall be capital expenditure. Hope you guys are getting it right. Next one, amount spent on lawyer's fees. Lawyer's fees to defend a suit claiming the factory site belonged to the plaintiff is a capital expense. So what is happening here? You already have a land. Somebody filed a case that the land is not yours. So you hired a lawyer to defend your case. A capital expenditure or a revenue expenditure? If I pay a lawyer for a legal consulting, lawyer fees is technically a revenue expense. Or I'm purchasing a land. When I'm purchasing a land, I take a lawyer's consultancy and I make sure all my property documents, everything gets verified and there are no problems with it. Now, when I'm buying a land, I'm taking an opinion of a lawyer. This is a capital expenditure. I have a lawyer who's constantly giving me some advice with regards to my operations of a business. It's a revenue expense. Now, keeping these two in mind, can you tell me whether it's a capital expenditure or revenue expenditure? Now, here, did the land belong to the owner? The answer is yes. The land belonged to the owner. So, you are just spending money to make sure that the plaintiff is defending your suit. This is basically you are trying to maintain property. In your name, so this becomes my not capital revenue, because you are not adding anything, you are just maintaining the property too. Now this I think should be a cakewalk for you guys. Expenses incurred on repairs and whitewashing for the first time on the purchase of an old building. I said let the building be old or new. For me, I am buying it, I am spending my money to revamp my old building. For me, it's still a new asset. So definitely not revenue, it's a capital expense. So the answer would be false again. Amount spent for construction of, I need to build a house. To build a house, I have been building some smaller huts around to make sure my house is built. Without building this, my house will never get constructed. This expenditure is required for the purpose of my capital asset. So the answer is true. Good job, guys. Now let's try understanding what's a capital receipt and a revenue receipt. A revenue receipt is something which I get by selling my goods or services. Revenue receipt is something which I get by selling my goods or services. What is my capital receipt then? A capital receipt is something where I sell my long-term asset or I get by paying off my long-term so I get my money because of my long-term liability, that is I take loan, share capital, money invested into the business, I buy a land or sell a land, so all of this becomes a long-term asset. Now let's say I have purchased a land $10,000. I sold a land $20,000. I am a dealer of cloth. For a cloth dealer, purchase of land $10,000. Purchase of land $10,000 is a capital expenditure. Selling of land $20,000 is a capital receipt. Now, because I am selling this land for $20,000, I made a profit of $10,000. This $10,000 profit, what I made, is the only thing which is going to come in my income statement. So not the entire capital receipt comes in, only just a portion of my capital receipt comes in. This is the biggest difference in my capital receipt. So please understand, when I sell a land for $20,000 is not going to affect my profit and loss account. Only the profit portion just affects my P&L account. So let's just try looking into these five examples and tell me whether it's a capital or revenue. 10,000 rupees spent on director's trip abroad for purchase of capital asset. Without going that trip, can you buy the asset? The answer is no. So this becomes my capital. Trade receivables, debtors, this is because of my sale made, so it is a revenue receipt. Demolition of a building, yes, if you do not destroy a building, you cannot build a new one, therefore it becomes a capital expenditure. Again, this also was a capital expenditure. Insurance claim received on machinery is a capital asset. you received, because it got burnt, you got money from the insurance guys, the money what you have got from the insurance guys is going to be your capital receipt. Hope you guys have liked the video. If you have liked it, do pass on your comments. And if you require any notes or any of the doubts, do put it in your comment section. We shall be very happy to answer all of it.